Today is Monday, December the 11th. We're here at the state capitol to present this letter to Governor Nathan Deal. We have gotten over 36 signatures on this letter, and I'm going to read it to you. It has to do with the appointment consideration that he has given to judicial nominee Clint Bearden. I'll now read you this letter before we take it into the governor's office. It says, "Dear Governor Deal, I am writing on behalf of our members who attended the State versus Tisdale trial to inform you that we believe judicial nominee Clint Bearden tendered false testimony in the trial last week and thus is unqualified to serve as a Superior Court judge. Specifically, Mr. Bearden testified that candidates who attended the August 23rd, 2014 rally at Burt's Pumpkin Farm did not want to be video recorded. The state was unable to produce a single candidate who objected to being recorded at the rally in which you yourself were present, Mr. Deal. Mr. Bearden's testimony was impugned by all five of the statewide Republican candidates who were present for the event, and they all testified that they have no objections. These statewide candidates were all elected in November, including former Attorney General Sam Olens, Insurance Commissioner Ralph Hudgens, Labor Commissioner Mark Butler, Agricultural Commissioner Gary Black, and State School Superintendent Richard Woods. Mr. Hudgens even appeared a second time after Mr. Bearden attempted to contradict his testimony. In addition, Mr. Bearden claimed that he was not aware that the event was advertised publicly and not involved in the advertising of the event. Mr. Bearden's testimony was impugned by his own emails with Dawson County Republican Chair Linda Clary Umberger. In these emails, they discussed advertisements that were placed in local newspapers to promote the event. Mrs. Umberger also testified that she coordinated with him for the public event ads that showed him as the event contact person. Mr. Bearden initiated the forced removal and arrest of Nydia Tisdale despite having advertised the event as being public. For these reasons and more, we ask you, Governor Deal, to appoint one of the other more qualified candidates for the Northeastern Judicial Circuit bench." Thank you. We will now take this letter into Governor Deal's office and present it to him, along with nearly 36 signatures of members who have requested that he drop consideration of Clint Bearden as a nominee for the Superior Court in the Northeastern District. Are we ready? Just dropping a letter off for the governor.
Okay.
So quite a few of us have called expressing a concern that he's considering Clint Bearden for the judicial nominee position and the
Northeastern Circuit, and we had some issues of regarding his testimony last week, and where we believe he may have perjured himself. Also, his lack of support for the First Amendment, and we would ask that the governor consider him not to be qualified for the position of a Superior Court judge in the Northeastern Judicial Circuit. And these are some of our members who have signed. I would like to leave you this letter with, it's about 36 members who have signed and requested him to appoint one of the other more qualified candidates, which he already has under consideration.
All righty, thank you so much.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. We forgot to sign the guest book. Thank you.